And now that that fucking situation has been taken care of, I get to go and do the boss rush. So Megaman X 1, they designed the stages around all fighting all the original bosses, all the bosses again. And you're like, okay, that's cool. But now, you had those, you know, significantly long stages, and they didn't even need bosses. Now you get to fight all the old bosses again in their own little room. It's like a throwback to Mega Man 2. So I'm gonna cripple your ass. I'm just gonna whack on you. Did I ever mention how much I hate bosses that just become invincible and just to prolong the length of time it takes to kill them? I don't think I have. So I'm gonna mention it again. Oh, he did the one attack again. Those little magnets that you actually get the... Like, your version of the magnets are way better than his. This is basically just like... These are like shurikens that have a little bit of magnetism to them. Which, considering we're all made out of metal, is pretty fucking effective. There, how you like that? Just fucking threw a whole garage in your fucking face. Not sure if it's doing more damage or not, but there you go. Hope you like it. It's not like I need to conserve anything. Come on, man. It's not like I need to conserve because, you know, I'm only gonna need one weapon on each one of these bosses. And then when I'm done, I leave and I recharge all my stuff. And then I get to fight the final boss. So, here we got Flame Stag again. Flame Stag is pretty cool. The thing I noticed is that a couple of enemies in this game, when you revisit fighting them, they've changed their appearance slightly. So like this guy, he had the red flame before. Now he's got the blue flame. I don't think there's any difference in his fighting style, really. I mean, I think the enemies are a little bit angrier the second time you fight them. For obvious reasons. But they don't seem to fight you differently. But then I always use, like, the special attacks on them, so they usually get stun locked. So, I think it's more... They might be fighting more aggressively in their, you know, normal... not cheap way. So up here you have the little energy tanks, which I'm not going to abuse because I don't really need to. I'm just going to use them when I need them. And they respawn after every fight. I wish they were in a more easy to access place, but whatever. So this guy's a big letdown. So easy. Just catch him on fire. He is invincible when he's down there, but thankfully he doesn't linger. He does that shit real fast. I don't know if you can see, but he's getting bigger. Let's see if this works. I'll dash through your face. Hey, I actually didn't take damage that time. Because usually you have to do that thing just right, the flame attack, where you can actually hit the guy without taking damage. Really weird. It's almost like the charge kick from Mega Man 5, only way better and way longer. Actually, it's more like the flame attack from Kirby. It was a good game. Now, I'm pretty sure those are instant death spikes in the ceiling. I'm not going to be testing them because I am not that curious. However, that would be my assumption. So, it's almost like a throwback to fighting Bubble Man. And, he's nothing like Bubble Man at all, really. Bubble Man didn't shoot minions. And this guy doesn't even shoot fucking... He doesn't shoot anything at you. Every now and then he shoots a ring of bubbles at you, which are pathetic. And he takes like 10 minutes to shoot them. And, they suck. Occasionally those crabs will attack you with homing projectiles. So he's sort of like something between Bubble Man and Launch Octopus. But not as intimidating. Well, more intimidating than Bubble Man, because nothing is less intimidating than Bubble Man, but definitely less intimidating than Launch Octopus. So now, capsule number 5. Halfway done. Almost to the end of the game. We're slicing this motherfucker in pieces. Which is another guy. Pretty much just about every boss in this game has some variation of an invincibility move. For him, it's those little, when he swings the little chain around. You can't shoot him. But only if you're using the cutter, will they deflect it. I don't know if you could do a charge shot and that will unlock it, but I have no idea. Never understood why he turns into a fucking lightning rod. No reason in the middle of a match. I mean, he's a sponge, I think. Like, why a sponge? I didn't know sponges were supposed to be electromagnetic. No idea what's going on. He's a weird guy. All these bosses are really weird. Maybe why I like this game, because I'm weird. These bosses are weird. Now, get into the home stretch. Oh god, we gotta fight this guy again. I hate this guy so much. It takes so long. So I can't even hit him. I'm gonna try to charge him a shot and see and maybe if it does more damage and I can end this fucking suffering faster. Look, what the fuck? He is such a punk bitch. I hate him. I only used like one line of energy to do that charge attack. I wonder if... Oh. That seemed to have done more damage. And we keep doing that. But the only problem is every time I do that, I end up running into him because I hit the wall. If you're lucky, you can stun lock him like that. But it usually doesn't last long. There's a little invincibility freeze. This is one of the few instances in the game where the air dash is really effective. Because, like, you know, you don't need it, but it makes it a little bit easier. Because you don't have to fucking reset. Now, this is the thing I never got. He's swimming around in this fucking fluid. What the fuck is it? You think it's blood? Or oil? Or some miscellaneous fluid that is also maroon colored. I have no idea. I mean, I would guess oil because, you know, he's a robot. But I immediately think of blood as well because it kind of looks like blood. And they are vicious and human killers, but really, like, you're gonna just make a bath of blood and that's, you're gonna live in that? I don't know, that kind of doesn't make sense. It makes sense for an alligator to live in a pool of oil, you know, considering he's a robot. But I don't know what's going on. It's another weird thing. He'd have been way, way more fun if he didn't have that fucking ability to just, oh, I'm gonna be invincible for 10 minutes. So this is kind of weird. You think, I don't know what the crystal shot is supposed to be, like what kind of element. I would imagine some kind of an icy element. But, you know, Overdrive Ostrich, he was in the desert before, and now he's clearly in the tundra. And no fucks were given. You don't even care. He'll fucking run anywhere. Also, the terrain in this level is way different than the original. As you can probably see here. Though I didn't explore it very fully before, they didn't have hills that were that high. And if he jumps over the top of the screen, then you can't hit him, so. A little precautionary today, right? I think I'm down to the last one. Hopefully. This is gonna be Crystal Snail. So, I'm gonna pull up the magnets. Hopefully kill him before he kills me. Take your time. I got all day. He has like fucking three or four. Missed it. See, I dashed towards him because if you just shoot at him, then he'll just cover himself in a shell and fly away to protect himself. But it didn't work that time. He got on. He's on. Nice job, asshole. Just run into the wall and hit yourself, why don't you? This is working out pretty well. He's just fucking juggling himself, basically. You're the worst Street Fighter player ever, Crystal Snail. So now I blew up all the enemies. Now what? Oh, the whole thing starts exploding. Now Sigma is contacting me for no reason. And I'm in shock. Even though, I mean, remember that cutscene at the end of Mega Man X1 where Sigma appears and says, "Hey, I'm not dead. I'm totally gonna come back and kick your ass." Did Mega Man, like, not get that message? Was that just a message to us, the gamers? Like, breaking the fourth wall? Or was it just a message that he ignored? Like it was sent to him, but he didn't get it? I don't know. Because clearly he's surprised. And he really shouldn't be. Because we know that Sigma's still alive. I mean, it's not like Mega Man. Like, Mega Man really never really showed much emotion. But he was definitely never surprised that Wily was behind more bullshit. At least not really. I guess we were supposed to be more surprised than Mega Man was. Because Mega Man was just like... Mega Man's like very simplistic. He's like, I got a job to do. I gotta go save that Russian girl. I gotta go save that... I gotta go kill that Russian guy. So here we go. Final boss time. And there's Sigma looking like a fucking total boss. And he's got Zero. The real Zero. And Zero's fucking pissed. So they reanimated him. And they put them all back together. And he's gonna fucking kick my ass. Because he's totally jealous of my mad styles. Now this is the fucking best Zero music ever. One of my favorite themes of all time. I think this is probably the only time it ever gets used. I don't remember ever... when I think of Zero, I think of this theme. But I never can remember of any other instance where this theme is used. Because, like, he has a theme in Mega Man X3, and it's totally different. It's actually a lot like Guile's theme. Which I guess they were just on a kick. Like, everything goes with Guile's theme, am I right? So he's actually a lot more challenging than I'm making him look. You can easily kill him without taking any damage, but he's very predictive with his attacks. He has like zero time to let you fucking flung around. As soon as you're on the ground, he's shooting at you. As soon as you're in the air, he's charging at you. And as soon as you move, then he fucking attacks you. So now after I kick his ass, I'm like, "Dude, what's up, bro?" And he's like, "Oh, yeah, my bad. I'm good. I'm done fighting you. I'm gonna go fucking kill Sigma. So you go. I'm gonna go destroy the generator. You go kill Sigma, and I'll meet you back later." So he's just totally fine now. You're just fighting me for no reason, apparently. Which basically, it's the old video game trope that a good guy turns to a bad guy. And the only thing he needs is a good ass whooping to just, you know, jog his memory and bring him back to his senses. Which is apparently what happened. So now Zero's good again. And now Sigma, after I dropped like a fucking 30 fucking stories, didn't even feel it. I gotta fight Sigma. Sigma's pulling off fucking Wolverine bullshit. And here's the thing I like. Is that, remember Mega Man X1? His weakness in this form was against sparks. Now, most of his attacks are spark-based, which I don't think is a coincidence. I think he deliberately saw, like, "Oh, well, I have a weakness that I need to address. I'm weak to sparks for some reason. So let me build my next design where my strength is sparse. Let me make my greatest weakness my greatest strength. But he did it wrong, because now he's weak against fucking blades. So, I mean, look how much damage this shit's doing. He's way harder to dodge in this game than he was in Magnax 1. But, still pretty easy to deal with. The hardest part is that fucking laser attack that goes across the entire screen. That's kind of rough. Now, here's the thing. When the developers were making this game, they were told that, hey, we at Capcom, we're investing in this, like, crazy new technology, this crazy new tech chip that lets you manipulate 3D polygons in real time, which for the SNES is fucking incredible technology. So, we're going to force you guys to use it as much as you possibly can, because we want to actually, if we're going to put this expensive-ass shit in the game, in the fucking cartridge, we're going to make you use it. So, like, alright, fine, whatever. So, remember the bosses earlier that were polygony? Like a little sword that I always thought kind of looked like Sigma's sword from Mega Man X1. It was like, oh, cool, I'm fighting like old Sigma shit. It's really weird. Because what else would it be, right? Nothing else looked like it. And then you had the, I don't remember what else. So now you got Sigma. Sigma's head. Which, it's okay, I guess. It's cool. But this boss fight is fucking... it's pretty weak, actually. Because not only, like... not only does he have, like, no health bars, so it's like, okay, I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. But, he dies, like, in nothing. I mean, I literally just beat the entire game, and I only used one sub-tank. I could have probably shaved off another 5 minutes if I just avoided all the sub-tanks in the game. Because I only needed that first one that I got. But yeah, so now he's totally exploding. The whole fucking building is going up in flames, and he's being really cryptic. Like, he doesn't understand what the fuck Zero. Why did Zero do what he did? Zero's the last of the Doctor's creations. The Doctor being Dr. Wily. Which, why the fuck does Sigma know who Dr. Wily is completely beyond me. It doesn't make any sense. Because the only one who should know who Dr. Wily is are maybe Zero, because he was built by him. He might remember who he is. Just like Mega Man X remembers who Dr. Light is, because he keeps seeing the fucking capsules everywhere, and Dr. Light built him. Maybe the only other people that would know who Wily was would be historians, maybe. I don't know how big his history is to the culture of people in this time period. This is like 100 years after Mega Man 1. And everything's fucking crazy and dystopic. So there I am, checking out the fucking beach. I'm gonna fucking cuddle with Zero. No homo. So now we're gazing out over the water. See the explosion in the, I think that's it. Well, that's... I don't know if that's an explosion in the sun, in the horizon, or if that's just the sun setting. I don't know. But once again, we're treated to a cutscene, which is basically exactly the same as the old one from Mega Man 1, where Gargolite wishes everything could be peaceful, which is exactly why he built the first intelligent robot with a gun. That totally makes sense, right? Because you can only have peace by starting out by arming everyone, right? So, X was wondering, like, you know, when is there going to be peace? What do I have to do? How many people must I kill until we can finally have peace? Which, maybe should tell you something about your fucking horrible logic. And so, you know, I'm going to have to make a sacrifice eventually that can make guarantee peace forever. But I just wonder if I can do what it is. And the ending cutscene ends on the word or ellipses. The fuck? Like, they're just drip feeding this shit out. Like, they have a story to tell, but they don't want to tell it because they want to drag it out for 100 games and never finish. So now, Mega Man X1, I was just totally just walking down the street. having fun, just basking, just taking a victory lap over the entire world. But maybe next two, I'm like, man, fuck it. That was exhausting. I'm going to go ahead and just grab a bike and just cruise. And so they're doing a tradition of telling you the names of all the robots in the game, all the enemies, but not showing you any pictures. So that's really helpful. Thanks. Plus, this game doesn't even fucking have credits for the people that built the game. Anywhere. At all. Not one fuck is given to any of the people that built this fucking game. Which is a crime, really. It's really sad. They deserve credit. This game is awesome. And all the music was awesome. So, I mean, there's a lot of things I can complain about with, you know, why to do this, why to do that. But, overall, there's really little to complain about. It's a really great game. And this is a new thing that they're doing, where they demonstrate that they don't even show the enemies' names anymore, the pictures of them anymore. They just give you their name and they give you their number, which I take to mean that the RP is Reploid power, so like horsepower, except they don't have horses in the future. They just have Reploids, which is cool. I can accept that. Now we got through the 8 bosses. Agile. Fast as fuck, strong as fuck. Surge is pretty well balanced. Violin, really powerful. Slow as shit. Neo Sigma, which I think was just, that was his body, the regular one. And then, no one knows how strong Zero and Megaman X is, because apparently their potential has never been tapped or measured. So we'll never know. It'll never be determined. Here's the end. Thanks for playing, which is a great thing for any game to include. And there's the black clone Zero, which you only see if you actually save all of Zero's parts. So that was Mega Man X2.